This is Ken Go with Hassan Mead, Olympian, member of Track Club Elite, or Track Club Elite. Hassan, you were fairly vocal after the first presidential travel ban this year. Travel ban's been revised, reissued this week. How are you feeling about it now?
I think I saw something the other day. It's still cut down to 6 countries. I just reacted emotionally a little bit, you know, because being, my parents and myself are immigrants to this country, and I just thought it was, you know, targeting a smaller country that may not be as powerful as the other countries. I just had a little bit of my own personal experience about having to go through, extra long experience, expedition or processing when it comes to entering the country. And I had that when I was going to Australia. You know, I said something about that when I spoke with the ESPN people out there. So I just felt for those that were being, the victim of this, overgeneralizing, so that's, but I think it seems things are calmed down, and I applaud for those, a lot of the Supreme Court judges, whether it was D.C., Minneapolis, there's a couple of them that, that said that, they banned it and they said they didn't support it. So, I was glad to see those people within a higher power that stood up for those that, that couldn't stand up for themselves.
You're an American citizen, and you can travel under a U.S. passport, so In theory, you should have no trouble getting in and out of the country, right?
No, I grew up here. I've been here about 18 years. I got an American passport. But, when I say the situation about trying to enter Australia without... I have an American passport, but it was all about birthplace, and my since I was born in Somalia, and that instantly flanks, throws a flag about it and puts you in a certain category that's being overgeneralized, over stereotyped and all that. So it doesn't matter. You can born in a country and have a passport or parents from a certain country, and just because of that, you're being thrown in a pool that you may not be belonging to. So that was what I was vocal about originally, and I still am. And I think it's nice to see that it settled down. And I still, I hope people still stand up and support it, and get the situation all right.
You'll, I'm sure, be competing there actually again this year. Are you concerned about getting in and out of the country?
No, I'm not concerned. I think for a few reasons. One, it won't be the first time that, you got to go through extra processing in the airport. I've done that before. I have a U.S. passport, and, but at the end of the day, it's a small hassle. That's all it is. Running is my job, and I won't let it prevent me from that. But I'll go on with it, and if anything happens, I got a lot of people, whether it's my coaching staff, my agency, my parents, Like, people like Vin, USATF track and field behind us. So, so I think for me, I wasn't worried about myself, but it was more of those, the people that were not, didn't have the opportunity that I do, or the experience, or the people behind me that I do. So that was what I was originally brought up, but I'm not concerned at all.
Not anymore?
No.
What about the young people? Are you less concerned about them?
Because I got I got a friend of mine, Mohamed, who trains in, he's from Canada, but he trains up in Portland. I've been hearing people getting denied entering the States. So, he's a great guy. He's a great athlete. He changes what we do. He's one of my biggest competitors, and I hate to see him not to be get in, and he can't compete. When you look at pre-classic, you get a lot of, in terms of distance event, the whole meet itself, 90% of it comes from over the sea. So what are you gonna do? So it's just stuff like that is gonna be, I don't think they can hold it back, but it just takes a longer process to make it happen. So.
For sure.
Yeah.
Well, Mo, thanks for your time. Congratulations on your year last year, and best of luck in 2017.
Thank you very much. Thank you.